Hello everyone, in this lecture we are going to learn how to subplot in the Scilab. So till now we have discussed two types of plots. One is single plot, how to modify the axis and figure properties. Now in the second, after that video lecture, we have learned how to plot more than one graph or two or more graphs within a single window, and we called it as a multiplot. Okay, and in that also we have learned how to modify the axis and figure properties using only the Scilab editor without using the GUI or the graphical window. Now same thing we are going to learn in this video lecture also, how we can change the axis as well as figure properties to make our graph or make our plot more beautiful, more attractive using only the Scilab editor. So let's start. This is my Scilab editor and I have taken the same example which I have used in the multiplot. The independent variable x varies from minus 10 to plus 10 with a step size of 1. Two dependent variables, one is y1 equal to x square, another one is y2 which is equal to minus of x square. Okay, so now in the previous lecture I have plotted both y1 and y2 versus x in the same window and called it as multiplot. Now I will use the same window but different plots. All of you can see. So let's start with that. So what I have written is subplot. This command is used to do these subplots, and for that, since we have two graphs, I can use 2, 1, 1. So what this 2, 1, 1 represent? The main point is this. So here 2 represent number of rows, 1 represent number of column. So basically 2, 1 will create a column matrix with the only two rows. So row 1 and row 2, two rows, but there is will be only one column, which is column 1. Now next come to this one. So what we are this one represent basically the position of the graph. So now we are going to plot the graph at this position. Since we have two rows, so this will do, this will pick up the first row. That means if we create a matrix which has only one column and two rows, then the what will be the elements? A11, okay, and A21. These two elements will be there if we create a column matrix with two rows, A11 and A21. So this one corresponds to the location of A11. That means we are picking the first row. Okay, so now similarly subplot 2, 1, 2. So what will this do? We have created a matrix, column matrix, same we have written here, but this time we have written 2 here. So this corresponds to A21. That means the we have one column, so the column will remain same but the row will be 2. Okay, so now we will plot. So at location of the A11, we will plot our y1 versus x. So plot x, y1, and similarly here we will plot x, y2, and we will execute our code, and we can see the graphs have been plotted in the different window. One is there and another one is there. So this upper one will correspond to the location of A11, and the lower one will respond to the location of A21. And in case of A11, we have plotted y1 versus x, and in case of A21, we have plotted y2 versus x. Now the next thing is how to modify the properties of these graphs. So in case of multiplot, when we try to change the axis as well as figure properties, so we have to mention in the children for which graph we are going to change the which property. Okay, we have to specify, but here since the windows are different, therefore we can simply write our commands without specifying for which graph we are going to changing the axis as well as figure properties. How we can do that? So let us first change the properties corresponding to the plot of y1 versus x. and for that we will come here. So first of all we will give a x label, and what will be the x label? X axis. Okay, and what will be the y label? It will be same y axis. And what will be the title? Y1 versus x. Now let us execute this code. So one can see y1 versus x, y axis and x axis are coming on the top plot which is the location of a11. Why? Because we have written this after this command and before this command. So this will give the changes the x label, y label and title of the plot which is plotted in the location of a11. Okay, similarly now I will change the axis properties. Let us close this graphical window. Now I will change the axis properties of the plot corresponding to y1 versus x, and for that we can do, for example I want to change the fourth side. So first I will write a is equal to gca. GCA means get controlled on axis. Now I will change the font size. A dot font underscore size is equal to 4. Okay, and next thing is a dot thickness. So let us change the thickness of the graph also. This time a dot thickness is equal to 2. Okay, now I will change the thickness of the x label dot font size. So basically thickness here will be font size 2 a dot y underscore label dot font underscore size is equal to 2, and similarly a dot title dot font underscore size is equal to 2. Here also I will just set mark as 2. So let us run. So we can see the thickness of the window as well as the font size has been increased, but in case of the lower there will be no change because we have not written any command to modify the properties of the lower plot. The upper one has changed. Now let us modify the axis properties of the lower plot also. I will write this command, and this time I will reduce b for this lower one. Okay, and similarly I can write x label, y label and title also for the lower one. The x label, y label let us keep same, and mark change the title from y1 axis x to y2 versus x, and then execute the command. So as you can see the axis properties of both the lower as well as upper one has been changed. Now let's come to the figure properties. First I will change the figure properties of y1 versus x, then y2 versus x. So what comes in the figure properties? Thickness, fonts, color size, mark style, mark color size, different things are there. So let us first change the thickness. So a dot children dot children dot thickness. So as you can see, if you have if you have watched my previous video lecture, I have specified by writing one here that which this command will correspond to which graph. In case of multiple plot, we have to specify this because both the plots will be in the same window, and by writing here either 1 or 2 we can specify which of the properties of the which graph we are going to change. But since they are in the different window, so there is no need to write. We will simply write a dot children dot children thickness is equal to 2. Now a dot children dot children dot foreground. This will change the color. So let us keep it as black. Now a dot children dot children dot line underscore style is equal to 2. Okay, so now let us plot this graph again. So as you can see the line style has been changed and the thickness of the graph has also been changed. Okay, now let us come to the mark size, mark style. So first of all I will choose a dot children dot children dot mark underscore style is equal to 0. because zero corresponds to the circle. Then we will choose the size and color. So copy paste, copy paste. So first I will choose the size, which is equal to 8. Then I will choose the foreground, and I will choose the red one, which is equal to given by 5. Now I will again execute the program, and we can see we have plotted a nice graph with circular mark size of color red. Now similar type of graph we will plot here, and this time we do not need to change the figure properties different from the F1. We can keep same figure properties because we have mentioned on the top of the each graph. This, for example, here we have written y1 versus x, and here we have written y2 versus x. This is enough to differentiate between the two graphs. So now similarly we will copy this axis properties from here, figure properties from here, and paste here, and we'll change A to B. So we can use A also, but B will make the things more clear. So that's why I have written different symbols. Now again I will execute, and we can see the properties has been changed for both the y1 as well as y2. So in this way we can create a subplot and can change their graphical properties, including axis as well as figure properties. So this is the benefit of changing the properties using Scilab editor, that we can just copy and paste. But if we use this graphical window to change figure and axis properties, that it will be a great mess, and ultimately at the end the Scilab will stop working, and you will lose all the changes what you have made. And again, if you start the Scilab, you have to restart from the fresh. So this is the benefit of using Scilab editor. So again, if anyone has any doubt, please try to ask me in the comment. Feel free to ask. Thank you.